Alright, after we done that, we're gonna click go. I suggest you to run this test for 20-30 minutes. If by running this test by 20-30 minutes, you're not gonna see any artifacts. And by saying artifacts, I'm meaning like brown streaks or different color streaks or dots on your screen. If you're not gonna see those, means that your video card is 100% stable. Also, when you're overclocking the GPU and you're gonna reach its potential maximum frequency, screen can freeze up. And if your screen going to freeze up, please restart your computer. Just shut down your computer by pressing shut down button. Wait 5-7 seconds. Your computer gonna shut down. Wait, then after that, wait 10 seconds and boot your computer again. All right, so I'm not gonna wait 20 minutes. I already know my frequency. So I'm gonna click stop the test and I'm gonna increase by 20 megahertz more and run the same test. Click apply, run the same test. And I'm gonna do so till the video card gonna show, till my image going to fail, gonna behave differently, or gonna show some artifacts or freeze up. And also over here we have the GPU core information, memory core frequency information, and the temperature on the GPU. And I do not let my GPU temperature pass beyond 100 Celsius. 100 Celsius is the maximum stable point on the GPU frequency that I suggest you to go. So do not pass Celsius. My suggestion, if you don't want to burn your GPU, graphic processor unit. All right. So that could be a limit too. When you're going to reach to 96, 98 degrees Celsius on the test, I suggest you to stop overclock and just, you know, write down your settings and use those settings. Or till you're going to freeze up during the test or showing some artifacts. When you're gonna see some artifacts, you need to pull down your GPU or your memory by 10-15 megahertz down and test it again. Click apply over here, pull down by 20 or 10, click apply and test it again. And do so till you're not gonna see any artifacts. And then write down your frequency somewhere or remember that and use it all the time. All right. So I know for this video card, my stable frequencies is going to be 760. That's the stable, which is 120 megahertz over the stock, which is about 15-20% of the increase on the GPU frequency, which is nice. And it's gonna give me a good increase in the frames per second during the games, or in a good better score during my video benchmarks. Alright, after you found that the maximum frequency for your GPU, because my maximum frequency is 760, I can go in beyond that, but the temperature after 20-30 minutes getting up to 96 degrees Celsius, 94, 96, that's, I don't want to go beyond 94, 96. Even if I can squeeze 10 more megahertz, it's not gonna give me that too much boost in performance, but it's gonna give me around 100 degrees Celsius on my GPU, which is, I think, a little bit too hot, and I better to back up those extra 10 megahertz and make my video card just a little bit cooler. Alright, after you're done with your core clock, overclocking, or sometimes people saying GPU clock, graphic processor unit clock, we need to move to a memory clock. And the memory clock, it's the frequency on a video card board, which is, in this case, GDDR5, 1 gigabyte. So this is the frequency for it. Frequency it runs and passing the signals between the GPU and memory. and the computer. So it's 1620 megahertz by stock. However, your frequencies can be lower or higher. It depends to your brand and series. It doesn't matter if it's lower and higher, but just follow these techniques. As again, today I'm running EVGA GTX 465 Super Clock Edition, which has a little bit higher frequencies than a regular edition. All right. As I know, I got unlucky with my video card, and it's not mine, it's one of my friend, and I'm overclocking his computer to its maximum performance. So I'm gonna overclock his i7 and his video card, and he has the i7 860 on a P55 EVGA motherboard. So keep in mind, I'm gonna do a video guide on that as well. I'm gonna do a video guide on i7 930 on socket X58, which is my at home. So I'm gonna cover all the i7 overclocking guides, so don't miss it as well. But anyways, let's get back to the video. And he got unlucky with his video card, and his video card maximum stable frequencies is 1660, which is by 40 megahertz higher than the stock, which is kind of suck. I heard some people pushing 1700 megahertz and beyond the 1700, but his video card memory is kind of suck. Look like he got unlucky with this. And keep in mind, it doesn't mean if I'm pushing 760 that you will push that. Sometimes it can be by 10-20 megahertz higher or lower. It depends what kind of dice you got, what kind of memory you got, and what kind of dice on the GPU you got. Sometimes it can be highly overclockable, sometimes it can be kind of suck at overclocking. But as again, so I decided to keep my memory clock at the stock 1620 and not pushing that extra 40 megahertz. That 40 megahertz not gonna give me any performance boost at all, as I tested. It's just gonna heat up my CPU, my video card, and give me higher temperature, but the increase in performance is like almost zero. So I decided to keep it at stock. However, you can overclock your memory clock by same techniques, by 20 megahertz up, 20 megahertz up tested, 20 megahertz up tested. And if you're gonna see the artifacts, then you're done. You need to back up by 10, 15 megahertz down and test it again till it's gonna be stable without any artifacts. And as again, by saying artifacts, I mean different colors, lines, some lines coming, or freeze ups. All right, so as you can see, I'm running this and my temperature are good, and I'm running 760, and it's heat up the GPU as best as it can. So in the games, it's going to be a little bit lower than during this test, but I love this test because it's gonna bring your video card to its knees and test it the maximum, you know, potential, and bring the maximum heat, which is nice. All right, let me maybe, I think I cover everything in this tutorial. As again, my name is Alexander Moroz, and this video tutorial was recorded with Moroz Video Capture, the software that was developed by me to capture a game screen or to capture your desktop screen while you're doing your tutorials.